factor the following: x squared plus 9x plus 14. Since the lead coefficient is 1, that's an understood 1x squared, I will use what's called the AC method here. I will multiply the A coefficient and the C coefficient. So a little bit of side work here. 1 times 14 is 14. I need to find a pair of numbers that multiplies to 14 and adds to 7. The pair of numbers, I'm sorry, adds to 9. The pair of numbers that multiplies to 14 and adds to 9 is 2 and 7. So I'll use that pair of numbers to split up the middle term. So I'd have x squared plus 2x plus 7x plus 14. Now I have four terms and I will use the grouping technique. X squared plus 2x is x times x plus 2 plus 7x plus 14. That's 7 times x plus 2. So that's x plus 2 by x plus 7. And you can always check your work when factoring by multiplying it back out. I should be able to multiply out those two binomials to get to the trinomial x squared plus 9x minus, I'm sorry, plus 14. Exercise B, 15x squared plus 23x minus 28. There's no common factor. I see that we have this trinomial in descending order. So I will, again, use the AC method. 15 times negative 28. 15 times negative 28 is negative 420. I need to find a pair of numbers that multiplies to negative 420 and adds to 23. Since I'm multiplying to a negative, I know I have different signs. And so remember, when you have different signs, you really find a difference in numbers. So I'm going to start listing some pairs of numbers that multiply to 420. So I've got 1 and 420, 2 and 210, 3 and 140, 4 and 105. Let's see. 5 and 84. 6 and 70, 7 and 60, 8 won't work, 9 won't work, 10, 10 and 420, 11 won't work, 12 should work, 12 and 35, and I'm going to stop there because I notice that 12 and 35 have a difference of 23. So now since it's a positive 23, I would need a negative 12 and a positive 35. Using those to split up the middle term, I'd have 15x squared minus 12x plus 35x minus 28. Grouping. 15x squared minus 12x is the same as 3x by 5x minus 4. 35x plus 28 is the same as plus 7 times 5x minus 4. So the trinomial factors as 5x minus 4 by 3x plus 7. And again, you could multiply that back out to verify that it gives you the original trinomial. Six x squared plus 11xy plus 3y squared. All right, so notice that even though this has got x's and y's, it follows the same basic form. All right, the x squared, then x to the first, and then x to the zero, y to the zero, y to the first, and y to the second. So I can follow the same basic idea. Let's see, 6 times 3 is 18. Find a pair of numbers that multiplies to 18 and adds to 11. 2 and 9. So I have 6x squared, splitting up the middle term, plus 2xy plus 9xy plus 3y squared. Using grouping, 2x by 3x plus y. Right, first group, 2x by 3x plus y. The second group is 3y by 3x plus y. So that factors completely as 3x plus y by 2x plus 3y. And again, you can multiply this back out to verify that it's the factored form.